What's up, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Depeche Mode, and we're going back to their Ultra album. And in fact, I've gotten a couple requests from this album recently, so I wanted to get to those. I really appreciate when people engage with the channel and, you know, talk about tunes that they enjoy and they'd like to listen to and talk about. So one of the tunes that was requested from this one is Sister of Night. I got Ultra when it came out in 1997 as a teenager. I remember this song lyrically. When the person requested it, I, you know, was thinking, oh, okay, that one. And I remembered the lyrical themes more than the music. So the music might be interesting in terms of, you know, maybe I'm not remembering it right. If I do remember it at all, it had sort of a darker, again, kind of sonically seductive vibe, but we'll see. But that would certainly make sense, because what I remember about the lyrics is I remember that it's another song which speaks to sort of interpersonal passion and lust and the psychology of sex. But I think also there's like a, I don't know if desperation is the right word, but there's definitely sort of a sense that the situation is not entirely mutually consensual, or at least it feels complicated. And it's even more complicated because I think the narrator at different parts speaks like it's about him, like he's seeing this woman as a sort of inferno of passion, and he wants to like share that passion with her. And indeed, he's sort of saying like, you know, I feel it the same way you do, you know, so we should burn this passion together and sort of embrace that lust and that powerful fire. But then there's a later part where he's talking as if like she's not, number one, she's not entirely like comfortable with the situation. She feels insecure, so she's willing to lie down on the floor, but there's a suggestion that maybe it's not the best of situations. And also the narrator uses the term, he might be a great prize for you. Which is to say, then he's talking about another individual, not him, having the same passion with the woman in question. So when I was younger, when I was a teenager, I remember thinking maybe this was about a lady of the night, you know, sisters of night or sister of the night, lady of night, and maybe like a streetwalker, and you know, maybe not all of her customers are the most admirable or ethical fellows, and that she might be put into situations that make her uncomfortable, but because she's not really in a sort of, you know, interpersonal or economic condition to sort of, you know, put a foot down or make a stand, ultimately she is sort of coaxed into things that are perhaps less comfortable than she would like. So again, I'm not sure how it relates to the narrator in terms of there seem to be like three people that are referenced over the course of the song, but I do remember that the song speaks very much to like passion on an interpersonal, physical, lustful sort of manner. So that's what I remember. Let me know if you have a different take, or at least, you know, a more detailed take. Always welcome different opinions about lyrics and the way a song came together. So, or just, you know, greater information if you happen to have seen an interview about this song. So either way, this is Sister of Night from their album Ultra by Depeche Mode.
Sister of night, when the hunger descends and your body's afire, an inferno that never ends, an eternal flame that burns in desire.
That little sort of laser snap shows up in a few of their tracks.
When the longing returns, giving voice to the flame, calling you through flesh that burns, breaking down your will to move in for the kill. Embrace me.
understanding, it could just be about a lustful experience, you know, one night stand, if you will, and then it's like, maybe it was like, shit, you know, was I pushed into that? Did I do that because I, you know, I felt insecure in the moment, I sort of let it happen? Musically, the song is sort of where I remembered it, but a little more like touching and like graceful, emotional.
As you walk through the lines, you're desperate to impress, so you slide to the floor.
Descending melodic line there, sort of washed out and in the background.
Make such a perfect price,
their composition.
But the cold light of day will give the game away.
And again, is that like, you know, the next morning, like, shit, maybe you shouldn't have done that. Like, maybe that wasn't as good of an idea as it seemed in the moment.
Assure me, hey sister, I feel it too.
It's like a, you know, one of the things he's doing when he's talking to her, saying, I relate to you, like, I know what you're feeling. I feel the same thing, but, you know, take advantage of that.
I'm trembling, you heal me.
It's restorative.
Hey sister,
maybe.
I feel it too.
How you feel tomorrow. Isn't there a Shirelle song about that concept from many years ago? Oh, some of the music. Got these sweeping kind of ghostly kind of synths, but also that sort of tight groovy melody with the bass too. Fade, but admittedly a fade out ending, not my favorite, but hey, like I said, I think sometimes that relates to the label, and their sort of, you know, concerns about, you know, pressing and how long the record's going to be and, you know, how much it's going to cost and so on. So I don't know if that's you know, always the case when it comes to ending a song like that, but regardless of that issue, I really enjoyed that one. As I said, the music was a little different than I remembered. It was a little more tender, a little more sort of emotionally deep, rather than sort of kind of like wicked and, you know, sort of like seductive, groovy, like I was sort of remembering, even though I think there was a bit of that too. But regardless, the lyrics, again, I think they were sort of what I remembered, but again, I do think it was more about the narrator than I remembered. I do think there's another line where he makes reference to a he, but I'm not sure, you know, that could just be another person who, like, had an experience with this woman, but he's saying, you know, you thought maybe he was great, but the next day it wasn't, and, you know, I'm here, I can burn, like, passionately with you because I understand you, whereas maybe he didn't. So, again, I think there's a couple different ways you could take the lyrics, and I think maybe my interpretation about it being, you know, a streetwalker or a lady of the night in that respect might not be on point. It might be a more general sort of, exploration of the sort of concepts and themes related to sexual intimacy, especially when it's sort of like short term and not necessarily built on like deeper emotions and so on. It's not an expression of that. It's just kind of like a lustful, passionate connection in the moment, rather than, again, an expression of something that's longer and more deeply held. Regardless, let me know what you think. Let me know if you have another interpretation, or at least a more detailed interpretation, maybe something informed by something you've read online. Nevertheless, I always do appreciate other contributions. You know, the Depeche Mode people, I'll just keep saying it, who've commented on other reactions I've done. Some of the most knowledgeable and enthusiastic fans out there, so big shout to all you Depeche Mode fans. Let's keep the reactions going. Let's keep talking about the band and all their awesome albums. Awesome albums. Say that three times fast. Nevertheless, I do appreciate the people listening and watching. Have a good day, have a good night, and I'll see you next time. Peace.